Virtual reality have been criticized for being antisocial, and it's often annoying that you can't guide your friends or your customers while they are using your VR experience, be that images, video, or games. Today we're going to project the VR experience onto the screen using a Google Chromecast. That's coming up. Hello YouTube, I am KevinTheDane, and on this channel I'm giving you tips, tricks, and tutorials to help you master VRay and 3D Studio Max. For a long time, using a GearVR have been a solitary experience. That, however, has now come to an end. With the latest Oculus update, other people are now able to monitor the experience on the screen. This means that groups of people can see and comment on whatever the user is doing inside the virtual experience. This is a new feature in the latest Oculus app update, and according to Oculus, the GearVR is the first head-mounted device to support the Chromecast. So for this to work, you need to have an up-to-date version of both your Android OS and your Oculus app. If you haven't done so already, go and set up your Chromecast. I won't go into details about this, I just set up mine yesterday and everything was pretty straightforward. Just plug it in and power it on with the USB cable and follow the instructions on the screen. When the Chromecast is installed on your phone, go to the Oculus app and go to the library tab, and there is a new icon in the top right corner of your phone. Click the Chromecast icon and choose your device, and after a few seconds the Oculus logo will appear on the screen. If at first it fails, just stop casting and try to cast again. And there we have it, the Oculus logo is on the screen. Now you can pick a GearVR app directly from the Oculus app, or you can just plug it into the device and you go directly to the Oculus home. Now I picked the 360 Photos app and it should be showing on the screen behind me. Now this app is still a bit buggy. At least they fixed the issue that were causing the cube maps to be mirrored, but as you can see here, it's still taking a long time to load the local images. At least they had an update yesterday including this loading screen, so that you actually know that the app is working. Prior to that, I had a lot of people commenting that their images would not show in the 360 Photos app. But with a little bit of patience, and as you can see here, now the images are finally loaded, and if we pick one, you just go ahead and enjoy the view. Now on my device, this is a Galaxy S7. It runs pretty smoothly. I don't know how smooth it is on the screen, but at least in the glasses there is close to no lag at all. I have, however, heard from other people that there is a lot of lag, especially on the Galaxy S7, and probably also if you're using more intense apps like games or video, there will be a fair amount of lag. Now, if you do want another app for viewing your VR images, I think the Orbex Media Player from Otoy is pretty nice. But if you're rendering spherical stereo images, you will have to add _BT to the end of your file names. This will change the loading order to bottom top, which apparently is necessary if you're rendering with VRay, or even if you're rendering with Corona. Now, since you're already fiddling around with your GearVR, I think you should go and check out my VR game. It's called Galactic Gundown, and it's about shooting a lot of aliens. You can also sign up for a free beta key, and they will be available later this year. That's it for today. If you want to learn more about VRay or 3D Studio Max, go check out my channel. And as always, don't forget to like, subscribe, share, tweet, whatever floats your boat, and cut!